Hi and welcome everybody. Welcome to my very next CFD stream. Today we are doing a tutorial, as I have mentioned before. Please excuse that I haven't uploaded my previous stream session on volume of fluid and GPU cooling. I will do so this week. I have been busy and cutting videos from that, and it will be particularly useful to learn something about the post-processing that we are doing maybe at the end of this session as well, but maybe next session. Today we are focusing on a marine application, and it's going to be a tutorial. We are starting just like the last sessions, we are starting from our user guide right here, and that's your typical help file, and that's actually the most useful thing or the unique feature that I'd say, yep, that's very good of this program, SimCenter Star CCM Plus, because, yeah, it has a lot of tutorials, a lot of theory, and everything explained. If you're, if it's installed at your place, with your local installation of SimCenter Star CCM Plus, you can find the user guide wherever you'd like to get help by just clicking on the question mark here down here on the attributes. And yeah, so basically what happens is when you click on this, it opens up a new browser window, and then you are in the Star CCM Plus documentation, which we call user guide. So, and here we are going for tutorials today because I want to get into marine simulation over the next streams. Of course, it's very important to start with some multiphase flow for this, especially going into volume of fluid, VOF simulation, and maybe some more as well. But today we are going right into that with the motion tutorials. And here we go into Lifeboat with Overset Mesh. Yeah. DFBI is, I guess it's direct fluid body interaction. I can look it up, but I don't know by heart. This means bodies are moving dependent on the forces that the fluids and other physics like gravity apply to them. It's not a prescribed motion. That's what DFBI means. So for this, we use an overset mesh to have this lifeboat. It's reworking an experiment. We are using this lifeboat to make it fall into the water surface. Yeah, with these parameters. So we are basically taking this model with 3 degrees of freedom. And then we are taking only the half the geometry, and then we are simulating it just falling down, splashing into the water. There's no ramp. The boat motion through the air can be pre-computed by classic physical equations. The simulation is started with the boat initially positioned just above the water surface with the following properties. 10,000 kilograms, so 10 tons. Moment of inertia, yeah, something. initial downward velocity, 22 meters per second. That's like 80 kilometers per hour. Holy moly, or 50 miles if you're watching from the other side and you need some freedom units in here. Yeah, initial inclination 35 degrees. Okay, so let's go. I almost have an empty simulation. I'm just deleting what is here. Yeah, that's just literally an empty scene. There's just some rubbish cylinder in here. Okay, let's get done with that. So I'm correcting my window right here so I can see it side by side like that. Have you been working on marine simulations before? Just let me know. If you have specific questions, I can collect them and come back to you, I guess. So, okay. So first, we need to import some mesh or CAD model. So, yeah, startup StarCCM Plus in a manner that's appropriate to your working environment and to create a new simulation. Done. Import the CAD model. File, import, import surface mesh. File, import, import surface mesh. And then navigate to my folder. Okay, CFD it is. I have done some stuff recently, it seems. Woof, Lifeboat. Here we go. Open, and it says, yeah, but I want to have a geometry scene after import. Okay. Okay, initially all parts of the imported are shown as solid gray surfaces with a boat hull hidden from sight. To see the hull shape in its imported orientation, click on save restore preset. Ah, that's here, I guess. And then views, minus Y, up, Z plus. There's a boat. Boaty Mac boat face is here. That's nice. Good. So, nice. So we can also see, like, that's the background. That's the overset. And in the overset, we have the lifeboat. Yes. And the symmetry plane. Yes. Okay. So I should save it. Going to same folder. CFD of lifeboat. Lifeboat 01 it is for me now. Cool, done. Next one. Creating regions. Create regions from the background and overset part. Multi-select geometry parts, background and overset nodes. So this one and this one, I guess. Assign parts to region. Yes. To be able to, stop. Set region mode to, a region for each part. Set boundary, create a boundary for each part surface. Do not create interfaces from contact. Apply and close. To be able to create an overset interface between the two regions, assign the overset mesh type to at least one boundary in the overset region. This boundary type applies to all boundary surfaces embedded in the background region. Do not form part of the boat hole. Boundaries of the overset region which are coplanar with boundaries of the background region must be assigned to the same boundary type. Okay, assign the boundary of each region to the correct type. Okay, let's go. So boundaries here. Back is symmetry plane, I've heard. No, first click wrong. Back is symmetry plane. Bottom is velocity inland. That's interesting. Velocity inland. Inlet is velocity inlet. And top also. I can also multi-select them. And then say velocity inlet. Symmetry is symmetry plane. And outlet is pressure outlet. That's interesting. So here we go. Overset. Overset. Boundaries. Here we go. This is boundaries. It's overset mesh. Symmetry will be symmetry plane, and lifeboat wall will be wall. Yay. Good. Yeah, looks like that, I guess. Next one. Selecting physics. So let me guess, we need a new physics continuum. Do we name it? Not yet. Okay. So we are taking three-dimensional. We are taking time, implicit unsteady. Yes. Otherwise, we are not able to drop. Multiphase and multiphase interaction. Yes. Automatically selected. Yes. Then we go for WOF. Oh, we take it laminar. And gravity. Gravity and waves. Cool. Cool. That was easy. Saving. Coupling the region. So we take the two regions. Do we have physics applied to both? Yes. Right click either selected node and select create interface over overset mesh. Okay, doing this. A new interface. This volume type interface provides coupling of solutions on the domain using automatically generated sets of acceptor cells on one mesh and donor cells on the other mesh. So we have overlapping meshes and one gives a solution and the other one receives a solution. Pretty neat. So save the simulation. Yes, I did. Generating the mesh. Okay. New. Geometry. Operations. New mesh. Automated mesh. So first we're meshing background. So we need a surface remesher and we use a trimmer here. Okay. Interesting. Yeah, that's going to be concurrent. No, not concurrent, parallel. So this is background. Interesting. So now we are duplicating this basically and saying this one is then not background, but overset, and we switch parts right here. Okay. So yeah, when generating mesh, to minimize errors in interpolating variables between the two meshes, use the same order of magnitude of grid density in the overlapping region of the overset and the background meshes. Ah, so basically same size of meshes outside of the boat and the surrounding where it will interact. To align the mesh and the overset mesh with the flow around the lifeboat as it moves through the water, generate the mesh with the lifeboat in horizontal position. Rotate the region to its initial position after the mesh creation. Aha, interesting. The grid must be finer around the boat hull and the water air interface to capture relevant flow details. Yes, that seems reasonable. I thought as much. Set up volumetric controls for each mesh type to help you achieve these goals. First, create blocks inside which finer meshes are generated. Okay. So we need a new block here, basically. Shape part block. And it shall be minus 28. So y is 0, z is minus 45 and 50 here, and 12 meters and 0. Ah, so this is basically the free water surface where the boat will hit the water surface, I suppose. Create this one. Okay. Close. And that's called overlap. Okay. Calling it overlap. And we need another block. You could have told me before. And that's going to be for the free water surface. 125, 125, 0 it is. 50. Come on. Minus 34. Minus 24. So we are expecting 10 meters of waves here. Probably. That's where we are going to refine everything. Okay, so we create it and we close it. Okay. Okay. Good. This is called water surface. Water surface, and because of reasons, I will make a new composite part here, which is not mentioned in the tutorial, and I'll call it refinement. And then I put these parts into my refinement. Cool. And then it says They want me to create another refinement called boat. New shape block. So this is minus 18, 0, minus 4, 4, 5, 8. Create, close. That's interesting. I think that's just like a waste of cells. Let's see, we'll just put this into here. So we can see, okay, this is going to be it. I will now measure how big this is supposed to be. So it's 4 meters rounded. And what I'm doing now is I'm just going to create an offset. Okay. I see. I can't do an offset of the boat. So that's why we have that block. Because that would be my first choice to say, okay, just create an overset of this. But maybe an offset, overset. Let's see if we can duplicate this and then make the lifeboat a new part. Say lifeboat hull, lifeboat, just like that. Putting this into here. This into here, because now I'm doing it as I wanted, and make an offset of this one right here, saying reorder, and saying 4 meters, and then I say execute. So how do we look? Yeah, that sounds better. It looks better than the rectangular shape, maybe. Let's take this as refinement, adding our own touch here. So boat, get out of here. Okay. So, hey, AAA 1029, how are you doing? Thank you for tuning in again. Okay. Okay, so we are back to meshing. Operations, background, default controls, base size 5 meters it is, and we need a new volumetric control. That's all, I guess. And this volume control is overlap, and overlap needs the overlap part in it. And yes, surface remesher. Okay, customizing it and saying it's 25%. Okay. And trimmer, custom isotropic size. Okay. So next one is is water surface, and we are putting not the tags, we are putting water surface in here, and then we say custom size, custom anisotropic size. Yes, activating both. Okay, and this one goes to 100%, and the trimmer X, Y, and Z. So let's see. Z should be 50. This is 100. This is 100. This is 50, and that's interesting. Okay. Okay. Align the mesh to the background region and change the mesh growth setting for volumetric controls. Ah, okay. Select background meshes, trimmed cell measure. Measure, trimmed cell measure. Perform mesh alignment. And then we go for mesh alignment location and say it's minus 125 here. So it's basically aligning there. Okay. And then we say surface growth rate to slow. Okay. Okay, that's it for the background mesh, I suppose. For now. Yeah. Let's go for the overset mesh. So here we want to have a base size of 1 meter. So we go here. Hey, it is 1 meter. Volumetric control overset. Yep. We need a volumetric control here for the boat. But instead of boat, we taking the offset here because it's better. Select the custom controls board, surface remesher. Yes, we'll do so. Values, custom size, 50%. And then we say, let's go mesh. That's going to be fast, I suppose. Okay, that's not a lot of cells. Yeah, that looks quite familiar to that image. Apart from mine being nicer. Okay. If you want to resolve wave propagation accurately, use a finer mesh along the water surface. Yeah, that's probably what I will do with my expert later on. Okay, cool, save the simulation. 30 minutes it should just run. On a 2.5 GHz processor score. From when is this? Does this still mean anything? Let's see later. Transforming the overset region. Right click on regions, overset, transform, translate. Transform, translate. Minus 26. Okay. Wait. We put it down, okay? Before rotating the lifeboat, specify, and I'm gonna save it as a new file now. Specify the coordinate system in which the boat is rotated. Create a coordinate system whose origin is taken as the center of mass of the boat after the translation. Okay. So, we are going for a new coordinate system just here. So we click on coordinate systems here and say new, say Cartesian. The origin needs to be that. Create, close. Origin, here we go. Just pasting this here. Yeah, that looks nice. Rename it to boat rotation. Boat rotation, okay. Do I need to do anything else? No, I don't think so. So, right click on regions, overset, transform, rotate, 35 degrees, 1010. Coordinate system, this one. Okay. Apply. So where's my rotation here right now? Okay. Okay, is it now visible here? Yeah, it is. That's good. Yeah, it looks familiar. Next one. Okay, we are creating our multiphase properties. So we go for models, multiphase, phase, new. And the first phase is called water. Okay, and then we go for models, select models, and this is going to be liquid, constant density, and that's all. And it's H2O, that's great. Next phase. Which is air, models, and it's going to be gas, constant density, and we say close. Cool. Water and air, okay. Yes, they are predefined. We can look here. That's air. That's nice. Okay, we save it again. Setting the DFBI motion and the 6 degree of freedom motion. Open tools motions. I do. The default is stationary. Yes. The motions. New DFBI rotation and translation node is added to the motion manager. Okay, select this motion within the motion specification. Hey, what's going on here? Sorry, just got interrupted. So selecting. Yeah, okay. So for Overset, under physics values, motion specification, motion, DFBI, yes, did so. Create the boat body and set its properties. Right click on the DFBI. Ah, here we go. DFBI new body 3D. Continuum body. Ah, okay, cool. So body surface. First it needs to be boat. Boaty Mac boat face. Okay. Select the body's boat node. And click custom editor. For body surface. Ah, here we go. Yeah, lifeboat wall. There's not so much that I can choose. Yeah, that's like only this one. Then body mass is 10,000 kilograms. Free motion. Yes. The body is allowed to rotate about the y-axis only to simulate motion in the head waves. This means that the moment of inertia around the y-axis must be defined. Initial values. Moment of inertia. Diagonal components must be 16,000, 16,000, 16,000, if I read correctly. Yes. Use center of mass. Yes. Initial values. Select the initial values, center of mass. To be, okay, didn't I copy this before? Ooh, it's here already. That's nice. And velocity is like minus 22. Yes. Select the DFBI 6 of bodies, boat, free motion. And say this is free motion, this is free motion, and this is free motion. So we have 3 degrees on freedom only and not 6. Okay, that's interesting. Yeah, it makes sense because we have like a... yeah, symmetry here. Okay, defining the WAF waves. The WAF waves model generates a number of field functions that are based on the wave parameters that you define. These field functions can be used as boundary and initial conditions in appropriate nodes on the object tree to create a WAF wave. WAF waves node in the physics. So here we go. Waves. New. And we say flat. A flat wave, that's interesting. Okay. And we call it flat wave. Flat wave. Point on water level 00 minus 30. Vertical direction is that. Current 0, wind 0. Yes, I didn't change them, so they must be correct. What is this wave now? Okay. Let's see what it will bring. Volume fraction, so setting initial conditions. Okay, we are setting initial conditions then. Physics 1, initial conditions. Volume fraction method composite. Composite water field function scalar function. Just searching for wave. Wof wave, flat wave, volume fraction of heavy fluid of flat wave. That looks nice. Okay. Air is field function, and then again wave. That's actually quite sophisticated. Volume fraction of light. Yes. Velocity. Field function. And we say wave again, wave after wave. Velocity of flat wave. Who could have thought? And pressure. We are going for the wave again. What? Sorry. Field function. Wave. Hydrostatic pressure of heavy fluid of wave. That looks nice. Setting the boundary conditions. The boundaries have been correctly set previously, so it only remains to set the conditions corresponding to each type. There are four boundaries in this geometry. No slip wall boundary on the hull. Symmetry. Yeah, no slip here. Pressure outlet in the right face. Yeah, probably here, yeah. Oh. Velocity inlet at all other remaining. Okay. Default conditions are suitable for the symmetry plane and no slip boundary. Wave conditions are applied to pressure outlet and the velocity. Nothing is prescribed at the overset boundaries. Ah, okay. So we are going through all the inlet conditions, I guess. Inlet. Inlet. Physics conditions. Velocity specification. Wait. Method. Components. physics values, velocity, field function, and then we are going for wave again. Do we do this? For all inlet boundaries. I think so. No, I think it's just like the left and the right one. Okay. Just a second. So inlet. Velocity method. Field function. Flat wave. Volume fraction. Composite. Composite. Water. Field function. Air. Field function. Water is wave again. Oops, that was too much. So it's volume fraction of heavy fluid. And here it is, wave, volume fraction of light fluid. Okay, yeah. Did that. Okay. I'm not sure if I need to do this for all. Should I have gone and combined these? Not sure. Maybe I have overseen a step here. So, outlet. Physics values. Physics values. Pressure. Field function. Field function. Wave. Hydrostatic pressure. Volume fraction. Composite. Water. Field function. Air. Field function. Water. Wave. Volume fraction. Heavy. Wave. Volume fraction of light. Where is my AI setting this up for me? Saving it. Bottom boundary. Ah, here we go. Bottom boundary. That's good. I was worrying. Velocity specification. Method components. Physics values. Velocity. Field function again. Velocity. Wave. Volume fraction. 1, 0. That's easy. Top boundary. So this can be closed. This can be closed. Outlet, I'm through. Top boundary. Velocity specification, switching to components. Physics values, velocity to field functions. And wave it is. And then we have 0, 1 as volume fraction here because it's pure air. Next one. Setting up solver parameters. It's necessary to set the time step. So time steps, let's clean it up. So geometry, close it. Regions, close it. DFBI, close it. Solvers, implicit unsteady. They want me to have a bigger 25. Okay. Finer mesh, smaller time step. Interesting. Second order. Okay. Ah. No, they are suggesting if I want to have the waves correctly, I need second order, but we're not doing this right here. Okay. Maximum inner iterations. That's under stopping criteria. 5. Yeah. Physical time. Yeah, let's leave it at that. And maximum steps. Nope, not doing this. Okay. Visualization. Let's see what they propose for visualization. So we create a scalar scene. That's interesting. New scene scalar. That's ugly. Scalar scene one is VOF water. No, not clicking that. So in the parts dialog. Nobody wants to see this, but we want to see this. So select symmetry regions and overset symmetry. Symmetry and okay, lifeboat and symmetry. Okay, that's interesting. Okay. Select scalar field. Volume fraction of water. Okay, interesting. To display overset cells, create an additional scene. Click scenes, volume fraction of water while holding left mouse button. Press control and drag. Ah, okay, this just copies it. So I press control and drag it here again, and then it says, yeah. And I'm gonna rename it to overset cells. Yeah, that's a T too much. Okay, let's just link the view and put it side by side. So overset cells. And select the scalar field. Yeah, I'm doing this right here. And set overset cell type for the function property. Overset cell type. Okay, save the simulation. Not sure what we will see here, but okay. Initialize and run. Initialize. Okay. Intertesting. I will make this color bar a little bit different because I don't like it that way. So maybe I just go for this and then of water. And just say, okay, I edit a copy here. I'm just editing this one here. Deleting that. This here, this one, that one, putting that all, oh, it should be white. Is it white? It is. Okay, cool. Now, something like this. So we have 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Okay, so we put them like that. Point 2. Point 4, point 6, and point 8. Now it needs to be reversed. And of course we need like this. What happens if we just say, please don't use auto, use smooth blended. Okay. No, maybe we just stick with auto for now. And the right side. Yeah, whatever. Okay. According to the tutorial, I should just hit run right now. Wow, that goes. Are we moving? We are. Okay. Obviously, we are moving, ladies and gentlemen. We have detected movement, so let us put some free surface here. Is this included in the tutorials? No, it's not. So we do this on our own. So as I have shown before, the easiest way to visualize this is an iso surface. So we do some. Yeah. And then do something which is volume fraction of water, create when we say, where is my derived part? Easel surface, volume fraction of water, and put it 2.5. Yeah. Second, we are putting the boat out of here. And I am adding the boat with some different, I'm just making here like a new surface. The outline can go. Free water. This is volume fraction. And this is Boaty Mac Boat Face. Boaty Mac Boat Face. So, simulation. I need my materials, so I'm going to import my rendering materials. Import. And CCM visual templates. If you ever need something special to visualize in Star CCM Plus, like a cool rendering materials, a unique color bar or something like that, just reach out to me. I can directly produce this live in stream and show you how. And I can then send it to you. So reach out to me via LinkedIn, Twitch, YouTube, or any other method you like to. Yeah, so maybe best LinkedIn. For those of you who don't know, that's me on LinkedIn. Okay, so here you go. Just connect with me and show me what you need. So rendering materials about to be imported. I guess they should be here. So Boaty Mac Boatface can be a preset and it will be, I have something in my mind for it. It will be Rescue Heli. Look at this wonderful guy. It is orange. Why don't I have free surface right here? No. Let's see what it will bring. Okay. So currently I have that overset, and if I now turn on, I wanted to go here, woof, I make it 16, but no, I just let it fit screen. Okay, so let's first put these axes away. I don't need them here. And when I now hit, let's check first how many render threads we are using. 32, limit this to 28, maybe for now, because otherwise my stream will be kind of busy. So let's go. Yeah, nothing happens. Very good, very good, very good. So, nothing really happens. We enable shadows and it takes at least a little bit longer. Yeah. Well, you can see it's rendered differently. So for free water surface, let's... Is this? Yeah, this is the surface. So let's go for transparent displayer, shall we? And say constant color. Now you can already see some problem with it, because you can see the overmesh, the overset here, right? And that's not what we want to see. I have described this in a previous stream, but I haven't uploaded it in to YouTube yet. But I will show again how we can make this look nicer. So first of all, turn it off again. And then we go for the derived parts. First, we are making a resampled volume. And for the size of the resampled volume, we will let's just create one. And then we are taking roundabout what we have entered as the water surface. Yeah, we have entered values here. So it was 250 meters in that size and 10 meters in that size. And the midpoint is minus 29, I guess. So 250 meters, 50 meters in that size. The mid is 25. Yeah, that's correct. Here we go for minus 29. And here we go for 10 meters. So, and then we make a second ISO surface, put it in here, and don't put these in here, but the resampled volume. And then we say, okay, free water. We have free water copy now. And we say we're not using this one right here. It's Boaty. Sorry, Boaty. Didn't mean to disturb you. I wanted to go for ISO surface copy. So let's take a look at the differences. That's our initial. And now we switch to. That's our initial. Off we go. That's interesting. That looks different. Maybe not perfect, but different. Okay. Let's increase this one here. Looks better, yeah, I'd say. Minimum voxel size can be bigger, for sure. Yeah, that looks better. Maybe that's a bit better for now. Okay. So let's make the volume fraction a matte display. Ah, we have some shadows here. That's interesting. Let's turn them into a matte display. Yeah. That's fine for now. If we want to have a better image, we turn this up here, and to speed up, we are going just 400 samples here, and 0.5 as noise reduction. Yes. Now that is a reasonable image, but let's for now turn off the advanced rendering and let's splash away. Is the boat really sinking into the water? It's just diving through the free surface. Okay. It could be that we see a reasonable speed up if we just close this for now. So we look at the residuals. And close this one here. Okay, if we don't have to refresh our images, our simulations get a tiny speed up, I suppose. And yes. What did I read? The simulation was supposed to be 30 minutes. I guess we are a little faster than that. Solution views. So for half a second, they said it's like 30 seconds. Okay. Yeah, well. it doesn't scale perfectly over multiple processor cores because we just have like a few thousand, like 50,000 cells here, but still. Yeah, we have splashed into the water. Yeah, this one is like the most useful display I have ever seen. I don't know what I see here, but okay. So let's see what we can do when we enable this here right now. Yay! We have splashed into the water. Okay, that was a quick one. Yeah, let's just close this for now and let it run full half second. So I'm entering the stopping criteria somewhere. Stopping criteria, maximum physical time, 0.5. Shouldn't take too long now. I don't even know where I read the time right now. Yeah. I think that's also some simulation that you can run on your laptop easily and that finishes in a reasonable time. Yeah. Or when you're at your university and have some potato hardware, then it still finishes in reasonable time. And hey! We have dived into the water right now. Okay, I guess we have done the tutorial. So, I will get some refreshments right now. And in 5 minutes, I guess we can start with the next tutorial, which will be DFBI boat rocking some waves, I guess. So, see you in a few minutes, I guess. Cheers.